Hi there, welcome to my channel. I have two more practices to do as a cloud practitioner in the cloud quest. I will go to the next one now. We can go through them together. I have done some of the previous ones you can see in this channel. You can go and see previous ones if you get stuck. So I will just start en route and see what the customer's problem is. So this is our new case. Disastrous environmental event. Sorry to hear what happened. Promotional event we held last week, increased our web traffic and load our website. All requests were being timed out. Posted in a basin which was affected by severe storms. We were flying for hours. I'm sorry this happened. Let's talk about how you can prevent this from happening again. First, use AWS to create auto-scaling groups across multiple availability zones to ensure that your resources aren't isolated. Second, create elastic load balancer to ensure that your network traffic is distributed equally across your servers. Okay, so if I spread them out over multiple availability zones, does that mean we will be 100% safe from any failures? No, system is 100% proof, but availability zones reside a geographically distinct location, so a singular event is likely to affect multiple availability zones simultaneously. Got it, but how do we verify if the size down is a different availability zone? Once you spread your EC2 instance over multiple availability zones, you can attach an elastic load balancer to your auto scaling group to ensure high availability and elasticity as well. You can monitor EC2 instance health by setting up a health check on elastic load balancer. This sounds promising. Can you build the system for us? Handle increased demand. Working sideline. Okay. Let's accept the task and move on. Multiple available create elastic global, attach auto scaling group to elastic global and create elastic point help check for EC2 instances. Now we will have some new video concepts to watch. After watching these videos, I will be back. Now, after completing all the video concepts, we can continue with our example, with our case. This is a classic web application architecture that leverages AWS cloud computing infrastructure. Amazon Route 53 provides DNS services to simplify domain management. Amazon CloudFront is used to deliver static and dynamic content. It caches frequently accessed content to decrease latency. Amazon S3 used to store static assets like images and video. And Amazon Elastic Load Balancer is used to spread traffic across multiple availability zones. Amazon EC2 auto scaling groups are deployed for redundancy. The auto scaling service creates groups of services that grow or shrink in capacity depending on demand. Auto scaling also works directly with Amazon CloudWatch for metrics that and data and with Elastic Load Balancing to add and remove hosts for load distribution. For example, if the web servers are reporting greater than 80% CPU utilization over a period of time, an additional web server could be quickly deployed and then automatically added to the load balancer. Let's go and see the plan. Create an application load balancer. Configure an auto-scaling group and connect it to an application load balancer. configure health check endpoint. And then what we need to do is configure an autoscaling group to include a new EC2 instance in third availability zone. Okay, third availability zone. Let's start practicing now. Implementing high available web applications, starting the lab. Click the lab and then open the VS Console. I will take this one out again. We need to open EC2. Then go to auto scaling groups, choose the one they have, review EC2 from here. Go to auto scaling groups. One minimum desired, minimum maximum capacity is one. Next one, instance management, review. Details, scroll down the network, go to, where is the instance management? Here. Waiting for the instances, review, and then details, and scroll down. Okay, this is here. Then we go to details, scroll down. What else? Subnet ID and load balancing. Subnet, network, subnet, load balancing, edit. Next, lab agency, subnet one. Okay, add a new load balancer. Need to add new one. Under load balancer type, choose application load balancer. This is taking a little bit of time. Application, okay. Application load for internet facing, okay. Choose under availability zones, subnet, choose all three availability zones. Choose the debate public subnet. Under this one, availability zones, public, select all of them, public and public. Create a target group. Okay. Choose this one and click go down, update. Create security group. Let me see. This needs to be updated first. Okay. Now we go to security groups. Create security group. We go to security groups. Okay, here. Create security group. Travel agency load balancer. Then second, allow access to the travel agency. Okay. I did that before. It wasn't successful. That's why it appears here again. I'm trying the second time. Okay, this one says choose, but I don't have option to choose. I don't know why. Okay, for we choose lab. For VPC, choose the lab travel agency VPC. You may have to click X to remove the existing. Ah, I see. I missed this part. I see now. Okay, this is what I've done wrong previously, I guess. I wasn't able to choose the correct one. And then I choose the latter region, click X to remove, and go to Add Rule. Okay. Inbound rules, add rule, HTTP is custom, this one, and the second one, outbound rules, HTTP, this will be, I'm going to remove this one and select SG. Let me see, 39 is not the same. G02 SG. We'll select this one. Travel agency, web server, security group. Next one, scroll down to bottom of the page and create security group. Okay, create security group. Now this is created. Select this one. Where do we go first? Click security groups. Here. Travel agency, web server. Okay. Edit inbound, now click, choose, okay, edit inbound rules, inbound rules, next, delete the one and click add rule, delete this one, again HTTP, and then custom travel agency load balancer. Travel agency load balancer. Okay, this one. We need to save the group, save the rule, and go load balancers, save the rule. This is what I got. Let's try again. Why? Security group ID. Local answer security. Let's see. Security groups. Select this one. Edit inbound rules. Finally, I don't know what happened there. Anyway, let's continue. Okay. Go to load balancers. Click one, choose clip description. Why is it not coming? I'll just go inside. Details. Scroll down. Edit security groups. Security. Edit security groups. I'm going from different places. Don't know, it didn't come up the same. Load balancer, choose, deselect. Deselect this one. Load balancer. Maybe it changed a little bit. Okay. We save this one. Now load balancers. Okay. Go to web servers. I need to go inside again. DNS name. Record. Doesn't have a copy. I'll just copy like this. Okay, paste it in the new tab. Okay. Now, in the same browser, tap on the end of the lab, type, then press enter. Health. Go. Type health. Okay. Okay. Target groups. Go to target groups. Target groups. This one. On the health checks. Click edit. Health check protocol. Advanced. IT 55.2.5 unhealthy threshold timeout to intervals 5 seconds. Success codes 200. And then save changes. Auto scaling groups. Choose network, scroll to network and click. go to network, launch network, we go to edit, click edit. Deselect first one and choose the second one. Let me see. Maybe this one. Update. Instances. Choose this one, networking review, submit ID, it's here. Oh, sorry. Instance terminate instance. Okay. Shutting down. Click. Okay. There's only one. Why do I have only one instance? Choose 5, 6. Let me try to update again. Okay. Now there is another instance. Auto scaling groups. Did I do anything before? Review click. Auto scaling travel agency. Okay. And then activity is to be scroll successful review. Okay. Okay. Auto scaling groups travel agency. Network. And go down. Choose both of them. not date. Auto scaling, group details. Group size. Two. Date. Again, back to auto scaling. Activity. Scroll down. Okay, successful. Okay. Now networking instances, choose instances running web servers. The one initializing networking. Submit. Networking. Submit. ID. Review. Private subnet. This says private subnet. My one is public subnet. I think I selected the wrong one. Let's go back. Private subnet, public subnet, private one and one, two, private subnet, public, private subnet one, private subnet two. Okay, now need to check if it's correct. Auto-scaling groups. Auto-scaling groups. Networking. Now this one is instances. Date. Okay. Networking. Public. Why is it public again? go back. Let's do from the beginning. Is it travel agency web servers? Auto scaling groups. Network. With private, private. This is updated. Okay. Next. Group details. Group details. Edit. Okay. This one is okay as well. Under desired capacity, okay, this one, okay. Activity, auto scaling groups. Activity. Scroll down. Go to instances now. This was just reviewing. Maybe I need to terminate before changing the security group. Running networking. Let's see if this is going to change anything. I need to probably terminate this once and start again. Okay. Final steps. This looks healthy. It's not private, but I did it public. Selected wrong. Let's go to DYI. Configure an auto scaling group to include a new EC2 instance in a third availability zone. We will verify that you have deployed a new EC2 load balancer within 3 hours. Okay, so I will delete them anyway. I will terminate these two. So I don't want to do it again, so we'll just terminate these ones. Okay. Let's go to auto scaling groups now. Auto scaling launch edit launch configuration network. Does it say any public or open streams or three availability zones? I'm going to select private one, private two. Private 3. I did public, it was wrong, I guess. I'll do these 3 now. Okay, group details, desired capacity 3, update. Okay, go to instances. Um, too runny? Why is it too runny? Okay. Let me see the practice again. Which step did I miss? Security groups. Subtidy. 2, 3. Okay, just need to go and see which step did I miss. Okay, we are terminating this instance now. Another one running. Auto scaling groups. Auto scaling groups. Activity. Launching new visit, terminating visit, waiting for a lock connection draining. Okay, I think they are 3 now. Let me see. Okay, I think it's working, just took a little bit of time. If we go to DYI again. So I was just a little bit in a rush. Load balancer. balancer name. Auto scaling group name. Date. Finally, this was, I think, the hardest one so far. I think I have one more to go. This is 11th as cloud practitioner. So this case was done as well. It's finished. This one had more tasks, instructions, and it took a little bit of time. And I was distracted with kids as well, so it distracts me a little bit. Okay. Let's get something. This looks okay. This is the reward we get. Okay, I have one more assignment to go, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.